Healthy hair growth check.
Hit the strip out of school, couldn't wait till I got out of class. Used to stare at the clock and shit. Before all this rap shit, I was gang banging and doing half beats on the cops and shit. And I'm straight from the shop, but I ball like a king up at Cali and shoot like Stojakovic. Keep applying that pressure, I go on the run. It ain't no letting up, ain't no stopping it. Had to tell my little brother to chill, gotta stay in the house. Come outside, he be popping shit. You ain't heard about us? Well, you need to go watch the news. Niggas know we be dropping shit. Got the feds on my ass in the hood, cause they think I'm the one who been banning them Glocks and shit. I'm just focused on music. They say my last tape was a classic, but I got some hottest.
So what's up, YouTube? It's your boy Kozak, and I'm back with yet another YouTube video for you guys. So today what I'm gonna be talking about is how I got my hair to grow so long. So I have a whole story, a whole journey that I've been going through with my hair. And I'm here to share that with you guys. So if you're interested, go ahead and hit the like button right now, because I'm about to give you key tips on how to grow your hair, how I got my hair so long, what I did, and my whole process, my journey. Not only that, I'm also going to be providing you guys with pictures and videos and all sorts of stuff. So yeah, that's something I hated about. Anytime I ever searched up hair videos, people would just, you know, they'll just show their hair now and recommend you products. They're not really telling you the whole journey that they went through with their hair and the whole process that they went through with their hair and da 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 da. And if you're looking at my hair now and you don't think it's very long, I guarantee you my hair is pretty long. I've been growing it now for 3 years. It's just shrinkage. So if I pull my hair out, right? And my hair is just nappy, but if I pull my hair down, it comes all the way down to my lip here. Let me get a smaller piece. Here we go. So yeah, my hair is this long, and this is about 3 years of growth. So yeah, let's get straight into it. If you didn't like the video already, go ahead and like the video. If you're new, go ahead and subscribe. I'll be hitting you guys with more bangers. If you have any more questions about my hair, leave it down in the comment section below. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get straight into it. So first thing first, let me give you a little bit of background about my hair. So about 3 years ago, I cut my hair. I'm gonna put a picture right here. There's gonna be pictures going along the side of the screen right here. So about 3 years ago, on July 4th, the 4th of July, which is actually tomorrow. So my hair will officially be 3 years old tomorrow. So on July 4th, that exact day, I decided to cut my hair. My hair was actually pretty long previously, but it wasn't as long as this. So this is like the longest my hair has ever been. But the reason I decided to cut my hair was because I wanted my hair to be more like a freestyle fro. Like I wanted to cut the sides of my hair, but I still wanted my hair to be like a fro on the top. And I couldn't achieve that. I didn't achieve that previously because back then I was just getting haircuts by like any barber, and you know, I was young. But what ended up happening was my barber kept on cutting like the sides of my hair, but also like cutting it up. So my hair ended up becoming basically like this. It basically became a box, and I didn't want a box, and I really disliked it. So because of that, and I knew like there was no way the sides of my hair were gonna be able to grow back in. At least this part of my hair was not gonna grow back in. It wasn't never gonna catch up to the rest of my hair. So I decided to start all the way over. And that day, I went really low. I went all the way low. And since that day, I've been growing my hair. So I took a picture every single month of the year for 3 years. And this is the process of my hair growing and how it grew and everything. So on the early stages, what I was doing was basically just putting in like growth products in my hair, doing like basically whatever I could possibly do to help my hair to grow at all. And I can tell you guys now, that is not gonna help your hair grow. Just because you put growth products in your hair and all sorts of products and whatever you try, that's not really gonna help your hair grow. Of course, it will promote hair growth. It might help your hair grow a little bit, but it's not the type of growth you're looking for. That's not where you're gonna get it from. So when my hair did eventually get long enough, I started to get my hair braided. So I let my hair grow like just out, which takes a pretty long time. If you just let your hair grow out wildly, it's gonna take you a very long time to get your hair to see results. So once my hair got long enough, I actually started to braid it. And once I started braiding it, that's when I started to see like real like growth. That's where the real growth is at. That is how you really grow your hair, whether your hair's straight, whatever sort of texture hair you have. Putting your hair in any sort of protective style is what's gonna make your hair really grow. That's where you're going to see, like, you're going to actually visibly see growth, literally. When, like, for example, I get my hair braided and it's in plaits, right? So I always keep it in for at least a month. So after a month, you can literally see, like, at the ends of your hair, at the root of your hair, right, from your scalp, you can literally see. So say your hair is braided, right? So I'm just gonna twist it, give you an example, right? So say your hair is braided, right? So all the way from the root of your scalp, it's gonna, if you get it braided well, it's gonna be tight right here, right? At first, it's gonna be tight and you probably could feel it on your scalp. Your brain might be pulsating and everything. But after a month, you'll start to see that it gets loose. And the reason it's getting loose is because that is new growth, that is new hair. That is literally new hair pulled out of your scalp. New growth that you can literally visibly see. And once you take out your hair, you'll see like your hair actually grew. Hair usually grows about a half an inch to an inch every month. So what braiding your hair does is gets you that maximum amount of growth and maybe even a little bit more. There's also something you can do, something that I was doing when I was getting my hair braided. Let me get the product. So give me a second. Step one, or tip, the first tip I got for you guys is take care of your hair. Just go ahead and take care of your hair, nurture it. If your hair is like, if you feel like your hair might be dirty or has products in it, you can wash out your hair with conditioner, not shampoo. Because what shampoo does is it's literally meant to literally clean out your hair. It's like washing your hands. It's literally meant to take everything out your hair, which means including your hair's natural oils that it needs to grow, including it all the natural oils and minerals that your hair needs to grow. It's gonna get all washed out, and your hair is going to have, your scalp is gonna have to reproduce all of that. So you don't want to keep stripping your hair of all of its moisture. It needs that oil to grow. If your hair is a little dry, put some more conditioner in it, whether it's oil, whether it's like a thick conditioner, whatever type of conditioner that works for you, go ahead and use it. I'm gonna show you what conditioners work for me. So I'm not someone who uses very many products in my hair. I've tried very many different products for my hair, and what works for me and what I think will work for most people or almost everyone, because of the type of product it is the first thing first is what I condition my hair with. Firstly is I will put hair oil or oil in my hair. I don't like thicker conditioners. I also use that, but thicker conditioners is something that you have to consistently wash out all the time, and you have to like consistently put it back in because it dries out quickly. So I'll like put oil in my hair because the oil is safe for my scalp and it's also safe for my actual hair. Conditioner is only meant for your hair. It's not really meant to go inside of your scalp. That's why you have to continuously wash it out. So the oil that I use right here, it is jojoba oil. It's right here on the screen. I'll put it on the side. So it's actually called jojoba oil. I just got this from Walmart, What it does is basically just an easy to absorb oil, or easy to absorb natural oil that comes from jojoba seeds or something. I don't know. I used to use coconut oil, but coconut oil kind of just stays on top of your hair. It never really gets absorbed by your hair or your scalp. It just kind of just stays there forever. And if it's hot outside, it'll kind of just run down the side of your face. This, on the other hand, is safe for your skin. You can put it on your skin and it gets absorbed into your skin. I also don't only use this for my hair, I use this for my skin as well. But it'll absorb into your skin, it'll go into your skin, it'll go into your hair, it'll go into your scalp, and it's easy to absorb, and then it'll stay there. And that's what I really like about this oil. It keeps your hair looking shiny and moisturized and not dry, and yeah. I'll squirt some, like 2 squirts of this in my hand. It says 1 for your hair, but I do what I want. And then I also use a thicker conditioner, which is this right here, this As I Am Grow Yogurt. You don't have to get this. This is a very expensive little bottle. This thing costs like $11 for this little tiny bottle. I'm putting it on screen here. And I'll also have the links to all of the products in the description. But yeah, so I'll mix that, put it together, and then put it in my hair like that. Usually after I get out the shower, have my hair a little wet. I don't want it too wet. I don't want it too soaked, because water, your hair absorbs water very quickly. So if you have too much water in your hair and you're putting products in your hair, your hair's not taking it in, really. It's just kind of just sitting on the outside of your hair. What's inside of your hair really is water. So I'll wet it a little bit. I'll keep it, like halfway wet, halfway dry, not soaking, And then that's when I'll put the product in. But yeah, that works for me, and it's been working for me, and it also is going to help your hair be moisturized and promote growth. Now, this last step, this last tip that I can give to you is what is the reason how I got my hair this long in such a short period of time. This is the best tip I could ever give you, besides any sort of like product, any sort of anything. This is like a real tip. The only real way to really grow your hair fast. There's no other way. No product can grow your hair fast. No, like by itself. No product can grow your hair fast. No pills, no anything can grow your hair fast by itself. This tip will grow your hair fast, even if you choose to use a product, whether you choose to use a product, whether you don't choose to use a product, this tip will actually make your hair grow. And that is to get your hair braided. Whether your hair is straight, whether your hair is curly, whether your hair is nappy, whatever it is, whether you're white, black, whatever you are, getting your hair braided will grow your hair, and you will get the most results, and you will get the quickest results from getting your hair braided. And the reason I say this is because putting your hair in any sort of protective style, doesn't have to be braids, it could be a 2-strand twist, it could be cornrows, whatever it is, any sort of protective style that you put your hair in is going to make your hair grow. Now, personally, from experience, from getting twists, cornrows, and all sorts of different braid styles and protective styles, what makes my hair grow the most is 3 different styles. So I'm gonna rank it, 1 being the best and 3 being like the least best but still good. Okay, number 1 would be getting my hair in cornrows, so straight backs. So when your hair is in straight backs like this here, that is what I see the most growth in. When I get my hair braided like that, after a month of having it like that, taking it out, I'll see like 2 inches of growth. And then that's just by itself. It's just because it's so tight and it's continuously pulling on your hair. It's literally pulling out hair from the roots, from your scalp. And that's that. And 2, which would be plaits, which is individual braids, is what that is. And here's a picture here. And plaits is the second thing that will make my hair grow. After a month of having plaits in my head, I'll see like an inch or an inch and a half of growth from my hair. And then number 3, which would be 2-strand twist. So 2-strand twist, they look very nice in my opinion. Here's a picture right here. But one, they don't last as long. They last, well, I'm sure you can make them last a month if you want, but for me, it usually only lasts around 2 weeks, maybe three if I stretch it, but usually not a month. But after I take it out, I'll see about like an inch of growth, maybe half an inch, or a little more than half an inch to an inch of growth. Now, a way to maximize, so that's your hair growing on its own, like just being conditioned and growing on its own. A way to maximize growth is after you get your hair braided, or after your braids are like fresh, say like you had them for a week or two, or it's in a protective style or anything like that, to put in this product right here. So this product, I'm gonna put it on screen here. It is called Wild Growth. You can get this from your local beauty supply store. I'm not sure if they have it at Walmart, but I'm positive they'll have it at any sort of local beauty supply store. If you can't find it there, I'm gonna put a link to it in the description on Amazon, and you can buy it there. This product is basically just a lot of essential things in here that like your hair needs, like essential oils and minerals, and it has jojoba oil in it, and coconut oil, and all sorts of different stuff in it. You can read the label yourself. But basically, what that's doing is, so once you always want to get your hair braided when your hair is clean. After that, I'll say after like a month of having your hair braided, not a month. I'm sorry. After a week of having your hair braided, I would recommend you start to put this in your scalp. And it's recommended to put this in your scalp, I think, twice. No. I think it says three times per week, which basically equals out to every other day. So one day you'll put it in. And the way you put this in, first of all, you want to shake it well. You want to shake it, make sure everything's good. Then the way you want to apply this, so we'll say I have braids or straight backs, right? So which means you should be able to see my scalp. So you want to get your hair braided. You don't want it to have like loose braids or loose plaits or anything. You want to be able to see your scalp, right? So say your hair is parted, right? So as you can see my scalp right here, and we'll pretend this right here is like a braid and it's going straight back, right? The way you would want to apply this is you want to take it, you'll open it, and you wouldn't squeeze it, because if you squeeze this bottle too much, it's gonna come out. You're just gonna kind of let it drip out, and you're just gonna go along each braid. So if you have individuals and say this is parted right here, right, we'll say it's like a square part, right, you'd go along, you go on your scalp around the braid. You would not put this in your hair, you would not put this in the braid. You want to put this on your scalp. It's meant for your scalp. So whether you have individuals, you'll do that with each individual braid, or if you have straight backs, you'll just go along each straight back like that until you're done. You know what I'm saying? Whether you have any sort of braids, you want to just go around and hit each part of your scalp that is exposed. You don't have to go inside of your scalp, you don't have to go into the braid and try to put it in there. It's just gonna mess up your braid. And then you would just let it drip out, you wouldn't squeeze it, because you're gonna have too much, and you just don't want too much in your hair. And what this product is gonna do for you is it's just going to add moisture, it's gonna add essential oils, it's gonna add essential minerals that your hair needs to grow, which is going to promote growth. It's like overwatering a plant. Like you give a plant sunlight and you give it too much water, a bunch of water. So your hair's already like producing its own oils, but you're giving it extra oils, right? So the flower's already getting a little bit of water, but you're giving it extra water. And then the flower grows and it becomes bigger than everyone else's flower. And everyone wonders, why is your flower bigger than everyone else's? Because you overfed it. And that's exactly what you'll be doing with your hair. Is you're going to be making sure it not only has enough, it's also going to get an abundance of it to the point where it can grow as long as it wants to grow. And that is the best tip I could possibly give to you. That's the realest tip. No matter how many hair videos you're going to watch, no matter whoever else you're going to watch and whoever else tips you're going to watch, this is the realest tip I could possibly give you. Because you will not find any better way, any quicker way to grow your hair than that. And I'm being real with you guys. But if your hair is at least 2 inches long, you have at least 2 inches of hair, you can get your hair braided. And you can double that quickly with this. So always, if you get your hair braided, always keep it in for at least 1 month. That is, if you want actual results, keep it in for at least 1 month. At least. You can keep it in for 2 months if you want. You'll get even better results, but at least 1 month. And then after that month, take it out. Let your hair breathe for a little. Wear your hair out for like a week or two. Make sure your hair is conditioned. Make sure you wash it after that. After you get it, after you're done being braided, make sure you wash it. And then go get braids again. But yeah, that's the realest advice I can give you, for real. And that's me. That's how I grew my hair. That's why my hair is the length it is right now. And I still got a long way to go, because I don't even know what I'm doing with my hair, to be honest. I just gonna let it grow until I don't feel like growing it anymore. But yeah, be sure to subscribe. And you see this video playing in the background, go ahead and watch it. It is called The Bullying Skit. Check it out. If you're new, subscribe. Scroll through my channel, check out all my videos. If you got any sort of questions, any questions about my hair, any questions about your hair, I will tell you this, I am not no hair specialist, all right? I'm just a guy who did a little bit of research on the internet and know a little bit. That's it. So you might know more than me, that's cool. If I said something incorrectly, feel free to correct me. I don't have a problem with it. If you see anyone asking for advice and you know the answer to it in the comments, answer them. Let's make this like a cool little calm community where people can express themselves and feel and learn something and feel okay and feel good. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. So go ahead and subscribe. Leave a like on this video if this was helpful to you at all in any way. If I told you anything you might not have known or really put you on and changed your life, leave a like on this video. And drop a comment down below. Ask me any sort of question about my hair. Ask me any questions about the products, any questions about anything. I'll be sure to answer it. I always reply to people in my comments. And subscribe and stick around. And if you have any recommendations, any other recommendations of another video I should make, leave it down in the comments. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.